So the last topics I want to talk about are advanced package deployment scenarios. The first set of packages that we saw were intended to be created by a continuous integration server. And the idea is that a CI server packages things at build time, just like if you were doing it by hand or using the Universal Package Explorer. You should include all of the same metadata, commit ID, branch name, build ID, any of the things that you have available to you from the CI server. It's important because this will be a disconnected package that you can always trace back to its source. What you can do is use a pre-release tag with no real semantic versioning. It could be like a date tag, a build ID, or anything like that. And in our case, we used a build ID because that was semantically easier, but it could also be a date stamp or timestamp. The point is that this allows somebody to communicate which package to deploy based on some number or something that a developer decided was a suitable package. And then as we saw at testing time, we can easily repackage this into a release candidate package. So that's how we interact with CI servers. CI server creates these with pre-release tags, and then we re-tag it to an even easier to use number, like an RC or something like that, and then just before production deployment, you drop the RC through another repackaging step. And the next advanced scenario that's nice to talk about is packages and branching using the Git flow. So the idea with Git flow is that you use Git branches to have features that you can test much earlier in the cycle without having to integrate the changes into a main branch. Of course, this presents a bit of a challenge when using packages. But the way to think about that is this. If you think about it, the branches are really just a particular type of metadata. So you can include those in your metadata and have your CI server use the same arbitrary way to identify the build number. If your CI server uses timestamp or whatever, it doesn't really matter. You'll have that same unique build number. It's just coming from a different source. But what you can do, though, is you can use another feature called build metadata. This is a feature of semantic versioning, and you do it with a plus. I like to add the branch name using plus feature or plus branch name or something like this. Basically, what this does is it allows humans to more easily pick this from a list. That way, you can still run it through the exact same process. And what's nice is you can use pipeline restrictions to determine if feature branches can be deployed and repackaged. There's a lot of people who will debate this. Should a feature branch go all the way to production? Should it be restricted? And I don't know, and that's really up to you to come up with those processes. But using Hedgehog, you can pretty easily restrict that using the pipeline restrictions that we saw earlier.